North and south, prisons soon bulged with unexchanged prisoners. Already inadequate prison camps became nightmares. The worst was the Confederate prison near Andersonville, Georgia. Meant to hold a maximum of 10,000 Northern prisoners, by August 1864, it had 33,000, the fifth largest city in the Confederacy. Its commandant, a German-Swiss immigrant named Henry Wirtz, forbade prisoners to build shelters. Most lived in holes scratched in the ground, covered by a blanket. The daily ration was a teaspoon of salt, 3 tablespoons of beans, and a half pint of cornmeal. A foul creek called Sweetwater Branch served as both drinking water and sewer.
One third of the original enclosure was swampy, a mud of liquid filth, voiding from the thousands, seething with maggots and fall activity. Death at the hands of the guards, though murder in cold blood, was merciful besides a systematic, studied, absolute murder inside by slow death.
In 1 year, 13,000 men died at Andersonville and were buried in mass graves.
Can those be men? Are they not really corpses? They lay there, most of them, quite still, but with a horrible look in their eyes. The dead there are not to be pitied as much as some of the living that have come from there, if they can be called living. Walt Whitman.
When I was taken prisoner, I weighed 165 pounds. And when I came out, I weighed 96 pounds and was considered stout compared with some I saw.
My heart aches for these poor wretches, Yankees though they are, and I am afraid God will suffer some terrible retribution to fall upon us for letting such things happen. If the Yankees should ever come to Southwest Georgia, and go to Anderson and see the graves there. God have mercy on the land.